Right, this one does have a kind of purpose, which is actually, I'm still having difficulty sitting on my own bum, which isn't good. It does actually have some scientificalness to it, a little bit. So we're going to get scientific. But it was one of those things where I was like, in the you do it too thing, with the whole loneliness and whatever. But it was going to be like, yeah, in the last 3 years, you'd be lonely too. If it had been 3 years, you'd be lonely too. Then it's the other thing about, like, there's been, you know, there hasn't been fuck all is it to say no to, really. But the problem is, I can't even figure that out. Can't even figure it out. If I think someone likes me, I instantly, because of this shit, instantly go, yeah, but remember, it's even more likely that I could be imagining it. That's how you start to, like, not be able to figure anything out. But also then knowing, that's the point, also then knowing that that kind of standoffishness and reluctance comes across as low self-confidence, doesn't really think a lot of himself. I don't think I want to go out with him anyway. Which then got me on
to the scientific nature of the interaction.
I want to talk about Johare's window. Have you heard of Johare's window? It should be called Johare's windows. Because there's fuck. So the first window is, I can see it, you can see it. So Mikey's loud. Mikey talks a lot. Mikey wears bright clothes. Mikey's a moody fucker. Mikey's always late. Those sorts of shit. You know, things that I know, things that you know. And then the second window is, you can see it, I can't see it. So, I don't know, I'm saying, fucking, she's fucking this and she's fucking that, da 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 da, and you're going, you fancy her. And then the third window is, I can see it and you can't see it. Now that's the shit I'm hiding. Or was hiding. There's pretty much nothing left. There's nothing that I was walking around with ashamed of myself for that I haven't gone, la! Because I just fucking had to. It's like, I've deliberately, ow! Ah. Oh, fuck off. This is really fucking painful, man. It's a big fucking, I know people would be laughing. This would be a social one. I get a lot of fucking pain from small things. And because it's a zit and because it's on my ass, people would be pissing themselves fucking laughing. And I'm angry and I get hurt easily and I'm in physical pain. And I'm always thinking, why is this much pain fucking funny to you? And me getting angry makes you laugh more. I want to fucking kill people when that shit happens. Because it's, they, again, are thinking that I'm going through nothing and it just looks hilarious. And this world is full of cruel fucking people who think it's just a fucking laugh. Go and Google the phrase, I was only joking. Particularly in a lot of feminism literature. But it's a fucking horrible phrase. It's in Games People Play as well by Burn. I was only joking is a fucking nasty phrase. Because it's like, they'll keep laughing as well. They'll keep doing it every time you move. Like, no, sorry, sorry. I'm like, fuck off. I'm in fucking pain. That's how I feel when people do it. And I know that they're just going, ah, they're having a little giggle to themselves. They think nothing's happening. And it's one of those, it's dangerous for me because I will fucking react to people. It's Mikey logic at its finest. It's where I don't match with the world. Laughing at my pain makes me want to fucking murder you. It really fucking does. I have to swallow that shit a lot. I just think it's not fucking funny. And then as soon as people see that you're actually upset, they're instantly offended. Instantly offended. You're instantly fucking rude. And I think, no, you were being rude. You fucking started it. That's one of the many examples where I don't fucking fit. But that would have probably be the sorts of things that I've got as well in window three. Because if I look sensitive, I look like a girly bloke and I look fucking like I want to do anything but fuck you, but I do like you. That's how it translates, being a nice guy. You know what I mean? There's a big focus on how much they don't want to fuck you, but they really like you. You're fucking amazing, but I really don't want to fuck you though. that would be disgusting. Everything else is lovely. That's how it gets drummed into you over the fucking years. Not people being nice, it gets drummed into you over the years. It's like, you are just sexually disgusting, that's all. And people might laugh at that and think I make too much of it. It's no, our subconscious learns from pain. Our subconscious learns from experience. I've had a lot of pain and a lot of experience. I've had all of these lessons hammered into me time and time and time and time again. And it still hasn't stopped. I still haven't settled down. I'm still at the fucking dating game. I've never left it. I'm still in that confusing state of finding someone that I connect with. And I don't think I ever have. Really, not fully. There's just always been elements of it. There's always been elements, but yeah, it's difficult. Anyway, this one was quite angry, but I don't care anymore. I just do get really fucking angry. I have to warn people about it and say, look, if this is a real fucking button for me, okay? Please don't fucking press it. Please don't fucking press it. You know what? If you ever, ever put up a little boundary because of your mental health, all you get is this, right, fuck. You know you're about to be talked about. You fucking know you're about to be talked about. Like, it's difficult. How does someone say, but I'm feeling paranoid, without being called a cunt, or without being told to just not worry? It doesn't work socially. Talking about mental health symptoms and how you have triggers that aren't your fault and they'll lead to bad consequences, in and of itself, leads to them feeling indignant, self-righteous, and justified in being a little bit fucking clippy and snippy with you. And then socially, again, you're like, here we go. Why does this keep happening? It presents in millions of fucking ways where the other person is thinking, that was a bit, bleh. They're just not as keen to chat to you. It's not like they're thinking anything bad's happened. It's not that they don't like you. They're just like, whatever. It's nothing. They forget instantly. And to you, it's like, fucking hell, again. It's the same lesson, just goes, bleh, and there's the silence that follows it. And you're just walking along thinking, yeah, no, everything's normal. That's what life can be like for me. There's these fucking flare-ups that happen off the back of a fucking assumptions. And I can't help but react to them sometimes. I'm a fucking nightmare. I'm high fucking maintenance. I'm very fucking high maintenance. I really am. You know, so, you know, again, society calls it high maintenance. It's not, it's someone who's in fucking banging trouble emotionally, and that's what, how it presents. It presents characteristically as a pain in the arse. But it's not. They're the people that fucking hate living a lot of the time. It's painful to live. It's painful to live. It can be. It can get weary to fight this fucking shit constantly and just be told that you're doing it because you're an overthinker. Stop thinking. Just stop thinking. Just stop thinking. It's infuriating. It's infuriating. It's like the world begs at you to reach out and you scream what's going on. Like, oh, it's not that. It's not that. No. I promise you that's why people aren't talking to you. I promise you that's why you're walking around going, why are people killing themselves? Why aren't people reaching out? You're all panicking about it. Because you're all telling them that nothing's happening when they do. That's what's fucking going on, guys. That is what's fucking going on. When what you think about this stuff does not translate into the way you respond to this stuff. It's always different when it presents in the moment. Oh, yeah, yeah, but no, because you said, and people are angry. People get really angry when you break society's rules and you make an assumption about them whilst they make an assumption about you. This world never makes sense to me. It always turns on me. And then I get angry with it. But it's always, suddenly people go, what? Out of nowhere, people are fucking right up there, indignant, angry with me. It's happened thousands of fucking times. No, it's not happening at the moment. Do you know why? Because I can't go out. That's why I can't go out. This shit flares up and I can't fucking control it. Anyway, then there's window four. Window four is, I can't see it, you can't see it. That's where all the problems are in everyone. Society tries to cure this by talking to window one. That's it in a nutshell. By talking to window one, by telling it. Like I say, you know, if you keep getting people who aren't interested in you when you try to like show them that you're interested in them, you will not feel attractive to people. If it keeps fucking happening, and it's been happening for fucking decades, you will always be fighting this lesson that was learned hundreds of years ago about how you're disgusting and whatever. every time someone's too busy, every time. And it's really hard to make a life with a load of people who already have one. Because I've got total knowledge of that. People have got their fucking lives and everyone is fucking busy. And I never matured into a healthy fucking network of people that I regularly see. And I know there's a lot of people like that. They're all in relationships. Everyone who says, yeah, I hardly ever go anywhere, they're all in relationships. Or they've got kids. That's their relationship. It's the long and short of it, mate. It's the long and short of it. Their fucking life is occupied with things to do with their partner. A great many people I know do fucking loads of shit that just at home with their partner. They're always in and around each other. Do you know what I mean? That's just fucking so common. I'm not saying it's what's meant to be or whatever. It's just the way it fucking is. And that's why those people aren't quite so fucking lonely and bored. And they're also tired. And their time at home is relaxing and fucking doing all that sort of shit. And it's when you're literally a fucking island. I am the islandest person I know. I really am. Well, no, there's a few I know on Facebook. There's a few people I know on Facebook who spend as much time alone and at odds with the world as me. And the world will always tell them it's their attitude and they're the reason that they're so fucking alone. And it's not. These people are people like me who've been bending over backwards to try and do all the things that they're told that they're doing wrong. And then when they talk about that, they're told, oh, stop listening to other people. It doesn't matter what other people think. It fucking does. Because no one wants to go anywhere near me. And then I'm told I'm popular. I don't get it. Everyone loves you, Mikey. I don't get it when people say that. People feel loved when they feel loved. Do you know what I mean? And I know there's people that love me, but there's, you know, friend love is friend love, isn't it? It's not as powerful. It's not love. It's not. It's you know, high regard, or you know, you think a lot of them. You think they're a cool person, or whatever. There's things that you admire about them, or there's things that they like bring to your life. That sort of shit. And because you think a lot of them, you love them. And it's like, we've got paradigms on that shit. We've all got paradigms on what I love you means. And it's, you know, my input and output of love have been toxified highly, highly, highly. I love you brings up all sorts of weird feelings in me. I love you brings up all sorts of weird feelings in me. I'm attracted to you brings up all sorts of weird feelings in me. And it's overwhelming feelings I can't control that make me look like I'm someone else. Because society has got, you know, all of the things that it thinks it knows about people, because it always thinks that it's looking through window too. I can't see it, you can. That's how society treats you. Treats you that it knows all about you because of all the assumptions it's already had inbuilt into its paradigms. Every person has got, well, that behaviour means that. That's how they translate it when they see it. That's how they operate. And when they're wrong, there's an extraordinarily high amount of miscommunication that takes place. I don't know if this video is too angry. I don't want it to be. I don't want to look like I've got a chip on my shoulder and that I'm saying none of you love me, because I know there's loads out there. It's just I don't have those deep loving connections. That's what I don't have, any of them. And that's what makes me fucking not feel loved. And then, so someone who I know doesn't love me, and I'm not expecting them to, goes, but I love you. And I think, well, yeah, you think a lot of me. But you thinking a lot of me doesn't change the fact that I'm daily fucking lonely and fucking depressed and fucking confused and trips to the shop blow the fucking shit out of me. That one that happened the other night, that sort of thing, that can happen any fucking time in my day. And it's suddenly like, and I'm just a jittery fuck up. That's why I'm not confident. You wouldn't be either. But there we go. It is a little bit scientific. I hope it makes sense. I'm going to watch it back before I publish it.